And there's the swing across to get the information. Spike will be planted. Dart comes out, but it gets shot immediately as Mummy's going to pick up two quick kills. Flashes are blinding them, but they're able to survive for the time being. Crashies has the gun pressed to the back of Gimon's skull, but he gets saved by his teammate after the shots don't quite connect. FNS also saved
towards that mid side. The bait from Kusa with a dash. Kusa going for the smokes to allow Sean to get the kills. Just super nice. Now this round, though, of course, Spike coming in. Of course, a full gun round for Genji and a rush in for Envy as they actually overtake at the beginning, but the trades come out, and now Envy takes the upper hand towards his C-site.
I love the pace control currently from Envy, understanding that they really didn't have a choice. They had to run in because they were working with SMGs. But as I say that, the collapse on the site is working out nicely. It's Sean against one. As he takes down Marv, he's got FNS on long, playing inside Cubby. FNS does not have util on the spike. Sean knows it. He's going to go for the dog around the corner, give away the position. Thought maybe he could catch him off guard, but no, Sean misreads. He thought he would have gone. Sean right around the corner with the Sheriff has to be careful. Verticality is not the name of the game. And again, it's a close round as the spike's been dropped. And this is just pistols. They've got one coming around the corner. It's Finesse.
30 seconds
left. He was really clutch for them in the previous round. Mikhail is backing off. Wisely so. I actually love this positional change. I don't think they're going to anticipate this, but as I say that, Finesse turns around and hold on. He didn't hit a single shot against Mikhail, who's going to send out his drone looking for the target. He's got his ult. There's an opportunity for him to hit this ult against that person, but no! The shock dart right on the money! As the ult comes through from Crashies, first pulse is right on the money. Follow up, just pulled left. But it's okay. Victor is there to hit the finishing blow, the follow-up damage, after quite a bit was dealt early on. The ult will be popped by Marv to get him into position. He peeks wide thinking he's safe, and Nature's just standing in the corner staring at him, wondering what he's thinking. But here's a run it back coming in from Victor as he flies in towards short, taken down by Kusta with the off. The knives come out from Kusta, and he'll slice and dice one. He's got his ult back in his hand, and it's all down to the last player. It's going to be Victor, low on HP, Spectre. Not as valuable necessarily as a rifle, but sight control is theirs. They do have locked down the Bladestorm to leverage as well. But FNS, doing what Steel did to them previously, just looking really strong as the Sentinel. There's the swing, the right click's coming out. Mummy wants one more with the pistol. He'll go for the floater. He is alone and hoping he can get some help. There's the ult coming out from Omen. Is this a bait, though? You can see they've got the nano swarm down. They're not really playing up on this quite yet. There's the peek coming through. Gimon will at least get one before having to back off. No one will get caught in this ult. And it doesn't really give them as much space as they may have anticipated or hoped for. But the spike will be planted nonetheless, and it will be a player advantage here. But look at the late lurk coming in from Marv. Marv is going to be huge here. He's got so much power in this position. There's the first. Had opportunity for the second and grabs it. Make it three on the round. Marv with that late. That
I'm familiar with from the years of watching esports in a different game is just set up the crossfire with the ecos. The first point of contact, having that rifle from the scalpers.
Fire so fast. So accurate from the hip. Spike will be planted. Mummy's going to hold the line with the op. There's the jump. Try to bait out a shot to give them space. It doesn't happen. Mummy's smart and just holding this line. I like the smoke coming out as well. There's the Seeker ult. The flash coming through. Oh, he gets stunned in hell. That's actually massive as they start to come out onto the site. Sean has made so much space off the back of that ult. You can see FNS was affected by it as well. And now it's a 1v2 as he goes up top. It's going to be Sean who comes in with a massive...
Maybe the new way that you're playing with this econ right now for this game. But let's go back with the action. We actually do have an aggressive push towards the C-site.
Sean comes through, but it's on to the doppelganger. It'll stop the ult, but Kusta is there with more punishing shots out of the op. Should they try to make their way out, he can do this and then do that. So he gets away. He gets an untradeable kill.
Tapping towards spawn. So now we force out the knives at least. Kusta moving up, Trailblazer on the other end, and crashes in a tough spot. That's it.
Bolt online, Bladestorm available. Nature's going to make first contact, and then Nature's going to get out of dodge, or at least try. Mummy getting a little too aggressive for him. Mikhail was at least able to pick up one, thanks to the help coming in from their Cypher Nature, who did the early damage. Seeker's coming out now, giving away position. Is it Alarmbot as well with a flank? Dog will come out, and FNS realizes he's got a move.
Smart.
The ult's coming through, but it's not actually really pinging anybody. So they'll start moving into position. Sean's going to be coming up on long. Time is starting to become a problem. Sean gets a freebie as the dart gives away positions, and now it puts all the pressure on Crashies yet again, who's been in that clutch seat so many times already. 1-2, can't get the third. But spotted some had they done it. Smoke's going to come out. There's a flash curveball coming in. Nature just times it well with the peak. Now they've got a two-player advantage as the spike tries to plant on B. A ping does come out, even though the recon dart was destroyed pretty much immediately. Shock darts coming out from Mikael as well as they shift into position for the retake. I like the play. I like the effort.
Oh my.
Vertical flying into the sky. They tried to make it work. Envy.
So that's paranoia.
Envy kind of fumbled this away. I felt like they really had themselves in a great position. There's the paranoia coming out, but he's going to have to swing so wide to get this kill that by the time he gets there, it's not even going to matter. The spike is...
Envy.
Big double coming out for Crashies with the Ghost. As he takes a brunt of the damage despite being right next to FNS. He's down to 40 HP, and again, they've fallen back. Realizing, okay, the value we gained is in the amount of sight control we have. This flash is going to be perfect as it hits him right in the face. Paranoia came in right around the same time, and now it's down to Nature. Nice.
He's trying to creep through. He's trying to isolate this at the same time. Mummy repositions close to the smoke. The right-click battle is happening, and it's going to be Mummy that takes it.
Freeze. Nice flash coming out. A great smoke. Paranoia is going to make things a little bit awkward here for Mummy. He plays close to the exit, and it pans out nicely. But Gen G is finding at least kills elsewhere at Gimon.
Strong. So this round, though, looks like we're just not going to waste any time. Here's an execute.
Quickly they go as they collapse onto the site. Great work from Kusta early on, hoping for a heal to come through, but not going to get it. And now it's come down to a 2-on-3. Nice shock dart to give some space for the team to work with. Allows them to set up the post plant. There's a dash in from Mummy, but just wasn't prepared for what was waiting on the other side. Cypher and Omen. Right around the corner is the Cypher, or the Sova, excuse me. And just as he tried to play the Cyber Cage, they do the same to him.
Oh!
They trade positions inside the smoke. They have no idea that FNS has managed to do this. He can't escape, obviously, because there's players on both sides. But still, the fact that he even gets that kill is incredible.
Yeah, and that because of that, though, Nature made it across. He could take spawn control. Victor was forced to go for an ult so that he could regain his health, but this opens the C site. So they could plant right now. They could fall back into site. They have Seekers. Now they have information on top of that, too, and two shock darts for pulse plant, where Michael is all the way back towards spawn site, but he's actually reflanking all the way through the garage.
Great move. Nice movement from Mummy. Totally catches Sean. Not expecting that at all as they dive out with two players. Nature's going to get both players coming through from Garage. That eliminates the threat of that late play coming through from Garage, but it's all up to Victor. He ulted from spawn, so they know that's the direction he's coming from. The hot hands is out. Nature going to...
...versus ND on an eco, but the Blade Storm is still available right now for Mummy and also a Sheriff to start things off over this A control. Now that means you're forcing into the B site because you know you're playing aggressively for NB on the start.
Enemy
for Gen G with the Blade Storm over towards the C site.
Oh, look at FNS's position. Should be able to scramble and get that one Phantom enemy under control, and he does. And that is a very fast round.
Why for this round and play for OT? Why not?
Coming out. Oh, this ult could do so much damage. Doesn't get the follow up, but look at the HP deficit currently on the attacking side. Hot hands goes in.
So
I mean, what are you gonna do? The flame spread to consume him on. It is a flawless round for Envy, playing close to the smoke. Does have a guiding light available, also has his lapdog standing by, ready to charge in and get more information. There's a flash coming out, and that's a positional change for Sean. He now uses the dog to get that information. Right around the corner is Kusta. Gimon was there as well, but Gimon was just a dummy target for them to fire at. It's now reduced to two players who are both low on HP. One much more so than the other. The shock dart at least comes G. You know, as much as we mentioned the pad, not like them being at 12 rounds, that last round not meaning that much, like it's...
They
still pushed on C long. That gives them so much map control, but they're kind of playing heavily towards A with four players and ignoring the B site. And since there's no player on C, there's not really support coming in through C connector. Now they go back towards A, there's Bruce short, and the gauntlet, the gunfight that takes place as they come out of C, A short, excuse me.
Mark, Jimmy's going to hear the
Jim
rotate.
He's limping.
I was going to say, Jim G could have hurt the rotate and then force and allow for Michael to fall back towards sewers. But Michael is in a tough spot. Because of that smoke, he's committed into this A cubby. It has to come down to GMD with a flank once again.
Yamon opts to actually go into sight instead of going heaven. And that could be a big problem. There is a player still in heaven. There's one in hell. Time is of the essence. It will be a map one victory for NV. I love this look from MV, the confidence to do this. There's a massive counter flash coming out and a return fire of the counter flash. Mikhail around the corner, burst fire and shots coming out, but it's not good enough. That'll be the Viper going down. Mummy's really trapped in a tight spot. Goes for the heal, but can't let it finish. That crash is coming in from spawn. The flash goes over his head. The dink right on the money with the burst fire, but it's not enough.
The amount of times that Sean's going to work down towards his showers. He did on pistol. Does it on second round. We're trying to paranoia peek. It's good for at least one on each side, but they're still trying to rush Sean right now, and now Envy takes the upper hand.
That's pretty big early on. A lot of damage being dealt. Snakebite, but he goes right on through. Not sure I like that play, as that's a brutal amount of damage to kind of just gobble up. The spike is down short, but look at the position.
Put into B is going to help for these close range battles.
I like that a little bit. I like the aggressive look, the confident play to peek on that. Tries to retreat, can't tell if he got hit by it. FNS dodges, not a bullet, but a large gelatinous orb. They'll fall back as they give up sight control, at least to a certain degree. Sean continuing that press, that fight towards elbow.
Yeah, it's a utility battle just to try to force him out, but on this 2v2, this big teleportation that comes out from Kusa to be able to plant towards the A side. I like that Sean stayed back just for a bit to see if he could catch a rotation out. But the thing is, they could potentially let this plant go down, but Mummy's going for the fight.
Sean didn't go showers, decides to go short. Spots one. Bullets coming through the wall aren't good enough. He still has a flash as well. 13 seconds left. They have no choice but to go for the plant. And Crashies knows it. Wants to get in there quick. Try and neutralize the planter. Doesn't get there fast enough. But look at the damage currently. The HP is so low. Shock dart. No, it's a recon dart. Coming out around the corner. That'll give away the position. Kusta tries to change up the angle, moving back towards short, but can't fool the utility. The paranoia comes in, but the wall is up first. That's a big play. Snakebite going around the corner. That'll drop Crashies into an awkward position. Mummy has to pop off from the corner, and he does. Mummy's going to get two, go for the heal as well. Recon dart will give away the position of a player back site if they peek past that smoke, but it's not going to happen. So now there's one trapped inside. Hookah, the shock dart will go out, but it's not even enough to damage Mummy weak enough to lose the duel against Sean.
And you'll take that any day, actually. So FNS dies, yes, of course, but at least you have Crashies that's still alive with the Hunter's Fury and also with the Owl Drone that's still up. So he could still delay for a bit while this rotate's coming back from Victor. And there you go. There's that Owl Drone that comes out that forces the rotate back, that has to kill noise and slow back on the rotate. And we'll see what we have coming out for our Envy right after.
Crashies trying to get away. Took significant damage from the nade that landed inside Hookah. Look at the ult coming out from Marv, though. They weren't prepared for that one. Somehow Marv gets behind enemy lines. They're trying to escape. The problem is they're getting pinched. Does Marv get this timing right? Yes, he's going to at least do some deep.
No more utility for the attackers, too. They just have to walk in.
Stay down.
Now you're committed towards this B site. Yeah, left. So tough.
Oh, this is actually big. That's a huge kill. That gives him enough time to at least guarantee the plant. Now, obviously, Mikhail is not in a great spot, given that both players are out here, but he actually had an isolating angle. He had an opportunity to fight 1v1, but it's not successful. Too slow moving for it to be too much of a threat. The dog actually misses the target, so it doesn't result in a daze or a stun on the target playing inside elbow. But it is a 5-on-5 full-strength retake. as Genji does everything in their power to prevent Envy from getting back on the site. We've got Gimon playing close to the exit. There's a Viper ult that's going to make things a little bit more uncomfortable. There's the rocket coming out. It takes out Sean, but it doesn't do anything about Nature, who's still hiding inside the smoke. Kusta right around the corner as well, waiting for Crashies to peek through, trying to play the timing on this one. There's Nature with that util coming out. They know where Nature's at. Nature now down on 79 HP, has to play a little bit more aggressively as both of his snake bites are already out, but it doesn't matter, it's a red. Who has a nade primed, just jump peeking currently. With the amount of long control they have right now, they do have the potential to pivot back towards A. But now that they've lost Nature, I'm not sure we're going to see that. There's the nade trade in Hookah as they play dodgeball on the B site.
You have this crossfire set up.
Victor, this round, proving how strong his arm is as he tries to throw those blast packs out as well. But these are two quick kills coming in for Genji. That's a massive flash as well. The information gathered and gained. Crashies has to peel back, has the ult to try to cancel. Will he hit in time? They're going to stick it anyway, so it doesn't matter. They know they needed it. But he doesn't actually get the kill necessary. Nice paranoia coming out as that flashes one off of the corner. Mummy has one inside the smoke, playing right on the other side. It was Sean, who was way low on HP. And now Kusta's alone. They heard the port sound. The shot comes through from Kusta, but it's not where it needs to be as Marv connects.
A bit more utility on these fakes or even on the hits. Yep. That's what I talked about. Tracer smokes here, Buck. That's what we needed to do.
Victor connecting, doing significant damage. They're not even prepared for the flank, and it doesn't even...
Or the B hits, and they're just able to hold the off angles.
Marv actually teleports inside a nade and takes nade damage as he spawns in. Not as bad as it could have been. It was only like one cluster, but still probably a bit annoying as they go ahead and go for this retake. I love the swing coming up from the Viper, stepping inside his own poison to take some additional damage but get the guaranteed kill. Crashies spamming down Mikhail, and at that point they're going to go ahead and stick the spike. They try at least. They're going to have to pull off and go halfway. Christ, this is something we've seen from Marv. He wants to get aggressive. He's not going to play patiently and wait for you to bring the fight to him. And that'll result in a player advantage that Genji was fighting for. And oh, that's unfortunate. Huge. Nice paranoia coming through. And now all of a sudden that swing could be a problem. There's a nade coming out. The ult gets pulled, but it doesn't work out so well. Victor's going to fall inside the site. That is what we've seen in a while. 35 seconds. They still haven't gained any semblance of control. They're trying to move past the Viper util, and it's costing them HP as they run through. Another wall is up. Sean's on site, getting shot from both angles. Envy gains site control. They're going to go ahead and get that spike planted.
Oh, he's sticking out!
They're trying so hard as Mummy is taking shots to the posterior, but it's not going to do enough damage to stop him from planting the spike.
Well, nice shock darts at least. We have still a bit of no utility actually left. Okay, the recon dart just came out. This is going to be huge right now. They're going to have to jump out, and as soon as the poison cloud is done, and here it comes, but a perfect crossfire set up for Envy, unfortunately, there. And it's going to be, you know what?
Significant damage. There's a blast pack onto site, and I'd love the maneuver to give them crazy amounts of site control, and Victor is just going to continue that charge. The paranoia misses, and that's at least a get for Genji. The site's been lost.
For spawn. They're planning for a spawn and Victor push. Yeah.
This is huge. I mean, Victor is just popping off at this point. This is the level of play we wanted to see from him when we talked about him underplaying in the previous series. Now, the wall was out long. It's been broken, but it's a 2-on-4. This is an incredibly pivotal round if Envy can win it.
They can. At this point, they just absolutely can. Because with the fact, yes, you're going to get a couple kills, but you had to teleport all the way towards the end. Well, okay. I don't want to cast curses. Take it, Mark.
I mean, it's looking pretty promising, considering.
Early utility already dispensed, so we're going to have a late rehit later on here for Envy.
Oh, no. I love this. I love this. Marv, he goes for the shadow step past the snake bite that's on the ground. So he avoids the damage from the Viper util and gets free kills, and now he's in heaven. They have no idea what he's doing. He's a snake in the grass, and he's slithered past the defense. The flash is perfect from Sean, and yet again, Sean is in a clutch position. We've seen him there so many times before, but it's a 1v3 with 46 health. A slow orb lands on top of his paddy that it was going to work out for him in the end. 12-4, Envy one round away from moving on in the tournament and also qualifying for the Challengers Finals coming up in August.
And that's how it could be so annoying. And now Gen G are just looking for anything right now. And Marv is looking, oh no, for another flank with his ult, but that forces GMD out of position, and Victor capitalizes on a kill.
Sean trying to fight his way out of that corner can only survive long enough to get one kill. Marv in spawn, gunned down by Kusta. The burst fire from the Bulldog is laser focused. It is a 3-on-3. You've got one in Hookah currently, with Viper lurking up in that area. Victor gonna go for the pin pull on the nade, tosses it out towards spawn, buys more time. Crashies is playing this corner perfectly. Just has to wait. Oh, gonna catch the timer. So that's a big kill. The dart's gonna be available now. There's the ult coming out as well. It's all down to one. It's Mikhail trying to fight to keep the team alive as the poison lands.